You thought you found a friend to take you out of this place. Someone you can lend a hand in return for grace. It's a beautiful.
And because it's a new year, we got a new studio, which means it's no longer Christmas. So I cannot say Merry Christmas at the beginning of the news anymore. Very sad. Anyways, talking about the news, this is the news. So Scarlett, Leah, and Mario are going to be joining me later today. This is the Coyote News. Please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please pause for a moment of silence.
Welcome back to a new year at Coyote Ridge. Wow. Here are the announcements for the week of January 4th through January 7th. The Robotics Club will meet Tuesday and Thursday this week. Please wait in the shaded area near the bus bay south. Student Council will meet Tuesday this week from 2:45 to 3:30. Please wait for Ms. Rosada and Mr. Crownover under the canopy by the basketball court and follow all school-wide behavior expectations. Thank you.
Welcome back, guys. The Young Authors Club will meet on Tuesday from 2:45 to 3:30. Please wait in the shaded area near the bus bay south. Just a reminder, STEAM clubs for grades 1st and 2nd are on Tuesday this week from 2:45 to 3:30. And grades 3rd through 5th grade will meet on Thursday from 2:45 to 3:30. Please meet in the science lab in F108. Thank you.
Hey guys, welcome back to a brand new year at Coyote Ridge. Art club will meet on Tuesdays from 2:50 to 3:50. Students, please wait under the canopy by the basketball courts for the art teacher to come pick you up. Participants must plan on being picked up by 3:50 p.m. to 4:05 p.m. Thanks.
It's basketball tryouts this Tuesday, January 4th from 2:45 to 4 o'clock. Anyone interested, please wait under the canopy for your coaches. Go Coyotes!
Middle school tutoring resumes its regular schedule this Tuesday, and then I'll go back to the normal Monday-Thursday schedule of the following week until 4 o'clock p.m. in Miss Ira's room. Remember to meet underneath the awning instead of Miss Ira's classroom if you want to go to tutoring. Congratulations to Miguel Arce in 8th grade and Nelly Duran in 7th grade for being the Spelling Bee champions and first runner-up. They will go on to represent Coyote Ridge at the District Spelling Bee. Good luck, guys. It is time for STEAM Facts of the Week. Although there's nothing really scientific about this one, but it's still kind of cool. Here are some of the top New Year's resolutions. So, what even are the top resolutions for the new year? Well, you see, Twitter's got us covered because they attempted to answer this question based on users' tweets. Here are the results of that. The first one is to diet, exercise, and weight loss. The second one is read more. The third one is to learn something new, maybe a new language. Number four is to save money. Number five is to be a nicer person. Number six is to get a new job. Number seven is to give more time and money to charity. Number 8 is to drink less. I hope they're talking about soda. Number 9 is to sleep more. And number 10 is to make new friends. So, what are your New Year resolutions anyways? And how long do you think you'll keep it up for? Because according to the University of Scranton, only 8% of those people who make New Year's resolutions only keep them. So, my New Year's resolutions is to breathe air. So I hope I don't quit that. That'd be bad.
Coyote card time. Teachers, make sure you are handing out those coyote cards and turning them into the bins in the office each week. In kindergarten, we have Mariah for being responsible. In first grade, we have Mark for being responsible. In second grade, we have Aiden F. for being responsible. In third grade, we have Leilani for being respectful. In fourth grade, we have Jimmy for being responsible. In fifth grade, we have Luis for being responsible. And in sixth grade, we have Kevin, Mateo, BJ for being safe. In seventh grade, we have Diego for being responsible. And in eighth grade, we have India for being respectful. If you heard your name, see Miss Mary in the office to receive your widget of wonder.
Birthdays! Here are the birthdays of the week. On Tuesday, we have Ricky Carell, Ayana Martinez, and Shane Moore celebrate their birthdays. On Wednesday, Christopher Guillermo Lopez celebrates his birthday. On Friday, Victoria Hernandez and Riley Morneo Santos and Ethan Borregoza celebrate their birthdays. Happy birthday, everyone.
For this week's Spotlight Minute, Mario got the chance to catch up with our new third grade teacher here at Coyote Ridge, Ms. Lynn.
Mario, go! Don't you remember how to do this?
Thanks, guys. We're here at the Reindeer Run to speak with our new third grade teacher, Miss Lydica. Thanks for taking the time to speak with us today. What is the greatest challenge or struggle you have ever faced?
The greatest challenge or struggle I've ever faced, I think, was the death of my father, actually.
Sad. Okay. What is your most random impulse buy?
My most random impulse buy was probably a huge collection of sugar skulls that I have.
Would you rather be forced to live the same day over and over again for a full year or take 3 years of the end of your life?
I would rather take 3 years off the end of my life.
What do you hope your co-workers say about you at your retirement party?
I hope that they say I was easy to work with and that I was cooperative.
What is your funniest work story to date?
My funnest work story is really a tough decision. I think it's that I worked here at Coyote Ridge in the past, and Mrs. Sika and Mrs. Acosta and a man named Mr. Dossett, they were my partners, and we all used to dress up together for all of the holidays.
Thank you again, Ms. Lydico, for letting us interview you today. Back to you in the studio.
Man, Mario, that was a pretty cool interview. But especially cooler is that was the first interview of the new year. Good job. But that first interview of the new year is the end of the first new year Coyote News we have. So always remember to be respectful, responsible, and safe, especially because it's a new year. And most of all, say it with us. Coyote Pride is hard to hide. See us next week, maybe next year.
Welcome to 2020.
Wow, that's a lot of years.